Across this great nation, there is a culture of people who carry on a heritage. They have an intangible quality that can't be described, but it comes from deep within their hearts. They share an appreciation for the greatest things that come from Mother Earth. They watch over, understand, and care for the vast wilds of this great country. Fishing, hunting, and trapping are the foundations that Canada was built on. For over two centuries, we have taken to the woods and water to pursue wild game. Today, it's about conservation, preservation, and wildlife management. Whether you are a man or woman, fish or hunt, you should support sound wildlife management and proudly say, I am an angler and hunter. The Ontario Federation of Anglers and Hunters proudly presents Angler and Hunter Television. Brought to you by Canadian Tire, a proud partner of Angler and Hunter Television, Mercury Marine and Lund Boats, Yamaha ATVs, Winchester Ammunition, Browning Firearms, Suffolk Fishing Line, Rapala, Camillus Knives, Excalibur Crossbows, and Yukon Gear.
You know, it's an exciting time to be a hunter in Ontario. Since we've reopened the spring bear hunt across the province, opportunities for hunting have increased, and in fact, I'm working on my own bear bait here. In fact, the setup here you see, I did an article in Ontario Outdoors. You can read about it. It's called Mike's Hard Candy. But basically, with this new spring season, there's outfitters all across the province catering to bear hunters. So if you don't have your own property like I do here, and can't bait your own bears, Ontario has full of fantastic bear hunting opportunities. By just going online and Googling Ontario Spring Bear Hunt, you'll see all the outfitters now that are offering bear hunts. Myself, I'm gonna head up to northeastern Ontario and experience some fantastic bear hunting with a guy named Gary Waldrum, and he's at Big Bear Down Outfitters. So this bait here I'll set up on my property, and I've got a few friends that'll probably want to come in here and bear hunt. But we're gonna take off, head up north, and experience some of northeastern Ontario's bears that haven't been hunted in over 15 years. Ontario has a very healthy population of black bears, but to get up close and have an opportunity to harvest one, you have to be in the right place. Northeastern Ontario is a veritable fishing and hunting playground. Countless lakes and rivers with wilderness as far as the eye can see. All conveniently connected by major urban areas from North Bay to Sudbury, all the way to Cochrane and Kapuskasing. Just east of North Bay and along the northern borders of Algonquin Park is the small community of Ruther Glen, where the Mattawa River flows through some of Ontario's most beautiful landscapes. It's also home to our host, Gary Waldrum of Big Bear Down Outfitters.
When it's a big bear, there's nothing like it. Your whole body shakes and you get pretty excited and pumped up. How you doing, Mike?
I'm good, nice to meet you, Gary.
Nice to meet you.
Not a bad drive up here, man.
Yeah, it's not that far from Toronto in that area.
No, and just behind us. So
nice.
Once he gets here, we'll get organized and make sure everybody knows what's what. And. Well, can you just show me around the place?
Yeah, come on inside and we'll have a look at the camp I built here.
Wow, this is cool. Angelo Lombardo and I are going to spend 3 days at the camp and hope to have success in the long-anticipated return to spring bear hunting in the area.
In years gone by, obviously, bear hunting for me has largely been the fall. As everyone knows, we haven't had a spring bear hunt since 1999, but being able to enjoy this great big game hunting opportunity is wonderful. It's a perfect time of year to be in the woods, especially where we are here in the North Bay area, in that winter has just left. Black flies are at a minimal right now, and an afternoon or morning sit, for that matter, is extremely enjoyable.
Yeah, it was quite the adventure last year when we started putting it up. And didn't take us much time. It took us about a weekend and a half to put this all together.
No kidding. Spacious. Boy, yep. A lot of people, this camp would be the envy of...
Pillow top...
mattresses.
Mattresses.
Wow. Nice wood stove, TV, nice. Dining shack next
door.
Yeah,
dining quarters next door. That way you guys can cook separately. That way the bears aren't coming up and sleeping with you next to you in bed.
So. No kidding. Big Bear Down is a pretty unique outfitter. Gary caters to Ontario residents and offers a very affordable two-night, three-day bear hunting experience.
Look at that, there's already a buffet here waiting for me.
Yeah.
Fridge, so lots of room in the fridge?
Yeah, full-size fridge, you know.
Perfect, okay. Griddle, stove, and of course the coffee machine.
Yeah, coffee, important.
Excellent, these are some of the bears here that you've taken over the last couple years?
Those are a couple, yeah. I still got a bunch of pictures that I haven't actually got them printed. Everybody's using digital nowadays, so.
Yeah, well, that's the problem, right? Yeah. We need a digital board up there. Excellent. Well, let's get settled in. We'll sight in the crossbows.
And yeah, that'd be perfect.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah.
This portion of Angler and Hunter Television brought to you by Yamaha ATVs.
With the late spring and the fact there was still snow in some areas of the woods, Angelo and I expected the action to be slow. There was a very respectable bear hitting the bait Angelo was sitting on, but it seemed to be only active at night.
So here's what I call the 4 mile stand.
You see?
Yeah.
So what's the lay of the land?
Right here, in behind, there's all kinds of water, still waters and swamps.
Yep.
And most of the time, you'll see them coming from the left-hand side.
Okay, it's a good setup.
Yeah.
Good setup.
Well, it was certainly great to be given the opportunity to come to Big Bear Down Outfitters. The nice thing about this location is it's close to downtown Toronto. 3-4 hour drive and you're here, wonderful bear country.
Looks like this barrel's been hit, Gary.
Yeah. It something's been at it.
Yeah.
Bear activity is starting. All bait seem to be active.
So what are you using for bait?
I've got a mixture of, like you can see here.
What do you have in with the corn?
Whole corn and deep fat briar juice that I get from a local chip wagon.
Yep.
And a bunch of renderings from a butcher.
Now usually how much bait do you put in the buckets?
I don't like to put a lot of bait in. I like to just come in with two buckets and put in just a little bit more than what you see here.
I see. Yep.
And that keeps the bears coming, and then they can still go off and eat their natural foods.
Right.
You know, I don't want them sitting here all night eating.
Right. Good.
So we'll get this baited back up again for this evening, and
we'll see what happens.
There we go.
It's just an absolutely wonderful time to be in the woods this time of year. The woods are coming alive, birds and all the little critters are coming out from a long winter's hibernation, and it certainly makes for an enjoyable afternoon sitting in the bear stand.
After getting Ange set up, Gary and I headed out for the stand I'd be sitting at. It's a bit of a hike, but in a fantastic location about a kilometer in from the side of the highway.
So Gary's just loading that bait up. Now he's using rotten meat, some grease, and a lot of animal fat in there, so it's going to be real ripe and rank smelling stuff. I'm going to just touch him up here. Rackstacker makes two products called It Takes Guts. He's got rotten and ripe. The ripe one is a berry smell, and the rotten one is, you don't want to smell it. Smells a lot like the bait you got going over there. But since he's using the rotten meat and the animal fat and stuff like that, I'm going to add a little bit of the ripe. Vultures are circling. Smells good already down here. I'm going to add a bit of that berry smell to it. It'll sweeten it up. And with this wind we got going today, between that dirty old stinky bait and this, pretty good chance we get something happening here.
Probably just pour some of that on those logs there.
Yeah. It smells like schnapps. Put a little vodka in there.
Almost like Yagi.
Yeah. You don't need much of it. Look at there's bear hair right there. That's probably about a 230 pounder.
Yeah. Well, I walked in, there was a 200 pound plus one here on Saturday.
Ah, so. Well, good news. Big Bear Down.
Right on.
Minutes after Gary left me and headed back to the highway, I already had a bear coming in.
Unbelievable. But Gary, literally, he just left me 2 minutes ago. I literally just got in this tree stand. I'm self-filming here, so bear with me.
Bears are ultra cautious and so highly tuned to their environment that any subtle change in smell or even sound will put them on edge.
I've lost sight of it.
In fact, setting a bait sight is truly the only effective way to get one in close and allow for a clean shot. This guy, however, knew something was up and never reappeared.
This is the end of day one at Big Bear Down Outfitter. Gary's coming out to get me, and it was an eventful one. No luck, though. I should get a shot at this stand, though, in the next couple days.
Back at the camp, we all shared our experiences from the day. And in fact, Gary's brother harvested his first black bear.
I haven't done a lot of bear hunting, actually. Bear hunting was new to me. I've mostly been a moose hunter for 30 years, and bear hunting seemed like something new to try. So there's a camp up here that my brother put in and decided to come up here and give it a try, and it took me 2 years, but I finally got one. Seen lots of bears, sows and cubs. Seen a big boar this week, probably about a 400-pound boar grazing in the field, which was really nice. So yeah, and I got my first bear tonight, which was pretty exciting.
Nice bear, Mark.
Gary had given me this, I don't know, it's like a berry stuff that he had given me. And he says, just put this on top of the barrel. So I did, I put it on top of the barrel, and that was the first thing he took. He stood up on top, licked all the top of this stuff right off, and that was it. And they laid down in front and finished feeding in front of the barrel.
And what do we got for weight there, Mark?
145.
I'm from Hamilton, Ontario. It takes me about four and a half hours to come up here, which is a lot nicer because a lot of the places we used to hunt would take us 10 hours or plus to go moose hunting and that. So it's nice, it's close, 4.5 hours. And man, it's pretty good. Bear hunting is pretty exciting.
This portion of Angler and Hunter Television brought to you by Minn Kota and Humminbird.
I was eager to get back to my stand early, as I knew last night's bear would most likely be coming back to the bait around the same time.
Day two at Big Bear Down Outfitters. Drastic change in weather. Not nearly as windy, and it's really warm. It's probably pushing 20 degrees today. Black flies started coming out. Is smelling really strong. It got hit. Nothing but chipmunks and squirrels down there right now. The scout look forecast says 5:07 p.m. is prime time, so we'll see. But here he comes. That's a fat bear. I'm gonna take this bear if he comes in. It's the same bear as last night. Easy 200 pounder. He's just short. What's that? He's being real cautious. Come on. idea how that just happened. I shot over his back. I know I shot over his back.
After I got back to camp, I went over the scenario with Gary and even took a few practice shots to make sure it was me and not my bow. Dead on, as I expected. However, we did review the footage and in super slow motion could see that my mechanical broadhead opened on the launch, causing it to lose its trajectory and touch the back shoulder of my bear. I was devastated, to say the least.
The Hunting Edge is brought to you by Winchester Ammunition.
To get the edge over this bear, I used the Excalibur Micro 355 loaded with a 125 grain broadhead. My camouflage is Yukon gear in Mossy Oak Country. I sweetened the bait sight with some rack stacker It Takes Guts Ripe. The weather for this hunt had clear skies, 22 degrees, and light winds from the south with a steady barometer. It was a tough night for me, but deep down I knew that bear would most likely be back. So I hit the stand early and settled in with hopes of getting another chance.
All I can do is hope for another chance.
Hours passed, and chipmunks, squirrels, and ravens were the only things moving. With only about an hour left of daylight, I started to collect my thoughts and accepted the fact that this incredible trip might end without a bear going down.
Every bear is different. Bears will come in. Some of them will just wander right into the bait stand, especially young bears. But a lot of the larger bears are very wary, very cautious. Could take 20 minutes, could take an hour. You may see them skirting through the woods around the bait site for a couple hours before they actually come in just before dark. I mean, like every bear has his own story and does things differently.
Got him. I got him. Yes. I
can't even explain.
I am.
Look at me. You'd think I just shot the world's largest bear. It's not about that. It's about outwitting him. And, having the patience, the confidence, and the equipment.
Wow.
I'm gonna go look for him. It'll be a while before Gary gets here, so while it's still light, I'm gonna go check the where I hit, see if there's any blood. Man, what a feeling. That's one of the hardest bears, hardest hunts. It was a good hit, I think.
Not an easy bear to follow. There he is. Yep, that's him.
Look at that. Wow. I gotta get my pack.
I'll tag him. And right here, look at this. Cut him just through the fat. That's my shot from last night.
After locating and tagging my bear, I had one of the most spine-tingling experiences of my life.
Get out of here.
A timber wolf ran right up on me and my bear. I shoot him away, but he was stubborn and began howling for what I guess is backup.
It's getting dark, so I'm gonna go to the road till we get some lights. Crazy, man. Crazy. I'm not hanging around there to find out how brave a wolf can be.
We came as fast as I could.
I mean, you know, it wasn't such a big deal, but I had my camera on the ground, and I'm just kind of shooting me, putting the tag in his nose and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And I heard something running up. Thought a deer maybe was coming. I get up, and there's a wolf running straight at me. He got maybe here to the pole.
Wild.
And I shoot him away. I stopped my foot, and then he went in behind me, and I started finished tagging him. And he started howling, man, like right there, calling in for reinforcements. So.
Yeah.
But we've got trail cameras in there. We haven't seen wolves.
Yeah, I have here.
No, but on our list.
Not in the last few days. No, right? He was here about a week ago, and I haven't seen him since.
Oh, well, anyway.
Well, we can go back in now, and the three of us, I got some bear spray with me if we need it.
Awesome. And that had to be one of my most memorable hunting experiences, and an excellent trip into the beautiful backcountry of northeastern Ontario. Truly an anglers and hunters paradise.
Finally got him.
Wow, what a story that is. That's a bear down, buddy. Man.
Closed captioning of Angler and Hunter Television is brought to you in part by Ontario Out of Doors Magazine. Angler and Hunter Television has been brought to you by Canadian Tire, Mercury Marine and Lund Boats, Yamaha ATVs, Winchester Ammunition, Browning Firearms, Suffolk Fishing Line, Rapala, Camillus Knives, Excalibur Crossbows, and Yukon Gear. For more information on the products used in this episode of Angler and Hunter Television, visit ahtv.com. Be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Remember, conserve and protect our great outdoors.